We're coming at you from the Staples Center in beautiful downtown. Los Angeles, as the Clippers prepare to take the floor. Last game for the Pacers, a loss to the Oklahoma City Thunder. And it's going to be...
The Pacers off the tip. Here's the starting group for the Indiana Pacers. Paul Millsap out there with Gallinari. Then it's Thomas. Then there's Teague. And it's Nurkic in at the pivot spot manning the middle. Here's Millsap. And he banks in the layup.
Defensively, that possession better not start a trend because they just handed him 2 points.
Here's the screen. Simmons dishes to Arthur. He kicks it to Bledsoe. A second chance effort. Adams' shot is off. Here's Indiana. Outside Thomas. Outside Millsap. Feeds it to Gallinari. Shot clock at 5. Indiana needs to get a shot off. Here's Nurkic. And it's the Clippers with the rebound. And Jusuf Nurkic, really a big, good-looking young prospect. He's the guy that took Mozgov's place in Denver.
Yeah, originally, Kevin, drafted by the Bulls at number 16, then traded to Denver, as you indicated. His sheer size alone, 7 feet, 280. It makes him a force on the glass.
Clippers on defense. Millsap a screen to the right side. Gallinari wide open. It's hauled in by Adams.
There's no getting around the simple fact that that's a shot he has to knock down.
Bledsoe kicks to Matthews. Bangs home the trifecta. Matthews has got a couple of threes now in the first for the Clippers.
You know what, guys? He can really light it up from the perimeter at times.
Thomas kicks to T. Here's Millsap. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
And Paul Millsap, guys, the only player to lead the NCAA in rebounding three straight seasons back in college. A former second-round pick, was kind of slept on, but now clearly making his mark in the NBA.
Jared Dudley's checked in for Gallinari. Greg, you were talking about Millsap's ferocious rebounding. He battles inside, but Clark, he is so skilled.
Yeah, he's just really a good all-around basketball player. He can pass, handle, step out, and hit the three. Very, very versatile. He makes an impact on the game a lot of ways.
The Pacers have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Thomas passes to Dudley. Millsap kicks to T. Back to Millsap. It's hauled in by Los Angeles.
They're 1 of 4 here to start, looking to get into a flow offensively.
Here's Dudley. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. Dudley's got his first basket of the night.
Yeah, and that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Yeah, and what a finish it was, guys. Really nicely done.
Here's Arthur. Los Angeles with another miss. For Indiana, they've gone 2 of 5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Screen by Nurkic. Dudley dishes to Nurkic. It's stolen by Arthur. Down low. And it's Matthews with the jam.
And that's the classic 1-2 punch right there. I mean, nice steal. And then how about the elevation, Kevin, on the finish?
And, Greg, nothing spurs some quick offense like a great play defensively.
That indicates the importance of great on-the-ball defense, as was displayed right there.
Back to Teague. 6 on the shot clock. Dishes it to Dudley. Fires the 3. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Lance Stevenson's check in for Indiana.
And they've gotten good looks, you know, so that's one reason they're frustrated. Maybe he can come up with something to get them an easy one. Maybe get to the line.
Yeah, you know, that may be the answer for them. But you know what else, Greg? Ultimately, I think because they're getting good shots, they'll make a better percentage of them going forward.
So the Pacers call timeout, their first of the game.
Yeah, maybe a change of the game plan right now, looking at some different sets because of the matchups.
Yeah, I agree with you, because they're looking to tweak things to maybe get those matchups working in their favor.
Arthur kicks to Matthews. They set the screen. And that one is good, Simmons.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
Thomas again, Bledsoe. Here's Nurkic. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Here's Simmons. And you can see his scoring totals. Those are some pretty good numbers. He's putting up close to 15 points a game on average. Matthews, no good. On the wing, Stevenson. Thomas down low. He's covered by Matthews. Stevenson passes to Millsap. Fades away. And the shot falls short this time.
Boy, Doc Rivers keeps on leading his teams to successful seasons. A former coach of the year rarely has a season where his team doesn't meet expectations.
Now here's Bledsoe. Quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. No good from Simmons. Matthews against Thomas. To the middle. It's stolen by Arthur. And here's the fast break. Here's Simmons. Takes it off the glass. Simmons got his second bucket of the night. And Doc Rivers passed the 700 win mark as a coach last season. He's climbing the ladder in career wins.
Yeah, and you know, I don't know that Doc oftentimes gets enough credit for the type of coach he is. I mean, as a coach, he is career win percentage. And how about over 500 in playoff games as well?
Here is Bledsoe. Following the basket by Lance Stephenson, Bledsoe kicks to Simmons. Pass to Arthur. From 18 feet away, no luck. So the Pacers will take it the other way.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
And out of bounds as Los Angeles gains possession.
And really just a lack of awareness on his part. Just no idea he was right near the line.
And it's a completely new group for Los Angeles. So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. Kuvis checked in for Yusuf Nurkic. Humphries comes in for Paul Millsap. Gerald Henderson, he's checked in for Jared Dudley. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Thomas. Just five to shoot. And the Clippers miss again. Augustine with it. Picked up by Rivers. Augustine again. Rivers. Kicks it out to Stephenson. Thomas with the block. Out of bounds. Pacers ball as Indiana keeps possession. Here's Humphries. That ball. Nice feed that time from Stephenson. L.A. has gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Out to the right wing. Plumlee dishes to Rivers. Now the feed to Thomas. And it's off from three-point range. Indiana trailing here. Henderson passes to Augustine. Now Humphries to the inside, and then Henderson with the jam.
Man, can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
And with Gerald Henderson Jr., what you see is what you get, a solid player, good athleticism, but he doesn't really specialize, Clark, in any one thing.
Well said, Kevin, right on the mark with that. He came into the league as a jack-of-all-trades kind of guy. Skills were somewhat unrefined. That's sort of where he is today. He is who he is.
The Pacers have gone 5 of 12 from the field since the opening tip. And Augustine kicks to Humphries. The pass to Henderson. Picked by Humphries. Augustine dishes to Henderson. The baseline J. Shot is off. So Los Angeles will take it the other way.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
Well, it always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass. Excellent, excellent box out there, keeping himself between the man and the basket.
Augustine with it. Picked up by Rivers. Augustine passes to Henderson. Here's Humphries. It's hauled in by Thomas. Looking at Los Angeles, they want to turn it around after the loss to Cleveland. From outside the arc, and that one's good. And now a four-point Clipper lead.
A good open look, and he splashes home the three.
And Augustine kicks to Henderson. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. Henderson's got five.
Great pass that time by DJ Augustine.
Thomas, a screen on Henderson. Thomas a screen. Kicks to Rivers. With the fadeaway. The shot is off. And Indiana will go the other way with it. Stevenson with it. Now Thomas defending. Passes it to Henderson. He nails it, and we're tied up. He has 7.
That's exactly why you don't leave your feet until the shooter elevates. He went for that pump fake, hook, line, and sinker.
Thomas a screen. Powell dishes to Thomas. That one drops for his 2nd bucket. Mark him 2 for 4. Here's Augustine. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. .104 left in the first. Here's Humphreys. Here's Stevenson. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. And what's your take, guys, on the hustle sticks for the Clippers?
Well, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
Yeah, and one thing, Clark, I've noticed is how quick their hands have been tonight. Thanks to that, they've gotten a lot of points off of turnover.
The Pacers making a switch here. Yusuf Nurkic, he's checked in for Kupas. Millsap comes in for Chris Humphries. Jeff Teague, he's checked in for Gerald Henderson. And Thomas subbed in for Augustine. The shot by Powell, no good.
You know, even though he missed that one, great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
No doubt about it. The defense, you can see him exhaling right now. Fortunate that he didn't knock that one down.
The one-hand slam is so sweet when it's his hand doing the slam.
Oh, yeah, he is so smooth, even on a power finish like that.
And really, that's what makes him unique, that combination of power and polish.
And here's Rivers, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Count that one. Rivers has got his 2nd bucket.
Yeah, heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
At the end of one, a closely contested game so far. Clippers ahead. They lead by a bucket. And back with the start of the 2nd quarter in just a moment. And the 2nd quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And taking a look at Los Angeles' performance here. What have they been doing or not doing?
And it's really about limiting their mistakes. And early on, they've been able to do that here in the first.
And, guys, I like what I've seen from them on the other end, forcing a few giveaways. And that's allowed them to widen that turnover margin.
Thomas is out there with Davis. Then it's Plumlee. And it's Rivers. And it's Powell in the shooting guard. They're the group out there for the Clippers starting the 2nd quarter. The Pacers making a switch here. Gallinari's checked in. A nice shot by Rivers.
That is a very low percentage shot, Kevin, but it's the result they were looking for at the end of the day.
Smith sets the pick for T. It's deflected. They retain possession. Goes back up. Shot is good in the Los Angeles leads. Cut down to 2 on the bucket from Augustine. And for the Clippers, they're shooting at 44%. Pretty reasonable. Powell kicks to Davis. The jump hook. And the shot is good. Dropping in off the front of the rim.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
Yeah, the defense is all about disrupting timing and spacing. And what they've got going right now is not getting it done.
He is an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
You know, he picks the simple one-handed stuff to get the 2 points.
Yeah, and in a close game, though, guys, those could be really important points.
Thomas. And the rebound goes to the Pacers.
Ill-advised shot there, Clark.
Yeah, exactly. That was lower than low percentage.
Here's Augustine. hits the front of the rim and out.
Most of the time, that shot will go down, or the defenders have to make sure they tag it.
Well, the Pacers, despite all their injuries from last season, were right in the playoff hunt until the very end. Had a chance, in fact, GA, on the last day to sneak in, but it didn't happen.
Yeah, they needed a Brooklyn loss to go along with them winning that last game. Ultimately, though, it wasn't in the cards for them, and they ended a game out of the postseason.
Millsap a screen. Here's the three. And Davis pulls it down. Davis has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Augustine against Rivers. Powell, the pass to Thomas. And there's the foul. It'll go on Ed Davis. That's his first foul.
Yeah, not afraid of the physical play, but he still needs to stay under control.
Yeah, he obviously was not under control right there. Not much doubt he was going to get whistled for the over-the-back call.
Millsap a screen. Here's Gallinari. Now in the scoring column with that deuce. 1 for 2 this game.
And, you know, the Pacers have made the playoffs in each of the last four seasons prior to last year's miss. Hard for a team that was coming off back-to-back conference finals appearances to stomach that. But with the injuries, they'll be better and back in the playoffs next year, I'm sure.
Here's Millsap. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play chance here. Isaiah Thomas, he's checked in for Augustine. The Pacers have gone 4 for 5 from the charity stripe in this one up to now.
And they've done some really nice work at the foul line, knocking down 80%.
That's been one of the strongest aspects of this team this season. I mean, there have been very few off nights for them at the free throw line.
Millsap with the steal. And it's slammed in by T.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into 2 easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
And really, it's going to be more of a reload than a rebuild situation for the Pacers. You would have to imagine their goal isn't just to get back to the playoffs, but to get back to being a conference final participant.
Now, here's Thomas. Taking a look at the scoring numbers. Right now, he averages about 9 points a game.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working beautifully.
It really is. 5 out of 6 of their last field goals have come from the paint.
Chris Humphries has checked in for the Pacers.
And guys, Josh Smith, an interesting blend of talents. A good defender, a great finisher around the rim. Also an underrated passer at times for a big man.
6 to shoot. Matthews into the lane. And it's Indiana's ball. They've gone on a 10-2 run, not allowing much. And it's Gallinari missing. Clippers trailed by 3. And Josh Smith, kind of a tweener. He spent some time at power forward. Clark, he spent some time at small forward. He's handled the ball. He's kind of all over the place.
Yeah, he is, but I think he's best, Kevin, working inside. He's gotten stronger. He's worked on his post game, and I think as time has passed, he's settled in as a full-time power forward. At least that's where he should settle into.
That's good. Wugzo's got his first bucket of the night.
Just such a well-rounded offensive player. He's got a little bit of everything.
And when you watch Wes Matthews, you see he's just a fantastic perimeter defender, Clark. He can match up well at either the 2 or the 3.
His combination, Kevin, of length and strength and lateral movement make him an outstanding defensive player.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over.
And for Matthews, you know, he knows that he's a strong defender. And so last year, his claim was that he was the best two-way shooting guard in the NBA.
So an entirely new group in now for Indiana. Kufis checked in for Humphries. Dudley comes in for Gallinari. And Stevenson's checked in for Jeff Teague. And DJ Augustine subbed in for Isaiah Thomas. Stevenson dishes to Kufis. Shot misses. So Los Angeles will take it the other way.
Listen, he has a chance to be considered the best two-way player at his position, and not sure if he is the clear-cut winner of that debate, but he is in the conversation. Wes Matthews, a hard-nosed player on the wing. Strong frame, and he really does put it to good use at both ends.
And Augustine kicks to Kufis. And here's Dudley for three.
Well, they're fortunate. The defense was taking a big chance leaving him that wide open behind the arc.
Wonsu kicks to Matthews. He dishes it to Arthur. And the layup's good off the glass. And the Clippers lead by two. Speaking of Matthews' strength, he really gets into you defensively.
Yeah, he wants to make you feel it. I mean, physical. And offensively, he likes to post up and back down the weaker, smaller defenders. I mean, you give him that mismatch, he will attack it with vigor.
Here is Dudley. The Clippers getting the bucket. That's good. Kufis has got his first 2 points. Augustine again, Bledsoe. Here's Simmons. He has six. And Bledsoe has it in the corner. That three off the mark. Indiana's got 0-2 from deep here in the second. The drive by Smith. And Augustine kicks to Smith. And good. Coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine. Augustine's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Now here's Matthews. He's got nine. The shot by Bledsoe. Nobody around. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Just a grinder. Always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. And that's one of the things he brings to the table.
Here's what the Clippers are going with right now. Miles Plumlee's checked in for Adams. Davis comes in for Jarrell Arthur. Thomas checked in for the Beast. And it's Austin Rivers in for Eric Bledsoe. Henderson passes to Augustine. Off target from outside. Clippers have gone 7-13 for the field since the start of the second. Rivers kicks to Thomas. It's good from long range. Thomas got 11.
There is no way a player like him can be left wide open like that. Did you pay attention to the scouting report?
Screen by Smith. Dudley dishes to Smith. Augustine in the corner. Stolen by Rivers. Inside. Here's Matthews. Kufis with the block. And they're able to recover.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Austin Rivers traded to the Clippers last year. A change of scenery did him well, and he was comfortable coming off the bench.
And that's a great point, Kevin. I mean, he seemed to get steady playing time, and that's what he needed most. And also, he wasn't defined by a position. They were able to find a niche role for him to play.
Teague drives in, and a missed layup. And here's Los Angeles. They're on a 12-4 run. The dish to Powell. He feeds it to Rivers. Davis up top. The Clippers need to get off a shot. Alley-oop try. Nurkic with the block. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. The Pacers making a change here. Stevenson's checked in.
And, you know, the role for Rivers last season was that of a bench scorer. I mean, not sure if he'll ever be a starter, but he can be a part of a winning basketball team with his skill set.
And Davis pulls it down. Los Angeles leading by five. Davis with a screen on Thomas. There's a whistle and it goes on Isaiah Thomas. That's his first foul. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Nurkic.
And with the trade last season, Rivers became the first son ever to play for his father. His dad, of course, being Doc Rivers.
Over to the wing. Puts one up from 19. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Another trip to the strike form. And I'll tell you what, a little bit of a different feel here in the second quarter. A little more banging going on.
Man, it has really served them well. Seeking out the contact you mentioned and putting pressure on the defense.
Catching up on the changes now for Indiana. Chris Humphries has checked in for Millsap. And it's Gallinari for Lance Stephenson. There's Gallinari with the three. And the basket good. Gallinari's got five.
And he found the perfect spot behind the arc there. Big gap in the deep.
Pass to Thomas. He kicks it to Powell. Back to Thomas. Just five to shoot. 11 feet out and he hits it. He's got 13.
And now he's taken a solid opening in the quarter and built on it here in the second.
Nurkic just screen on Rivers. Thomas. Here's Humphries. And the bucket counts, and he's on his way to the free throw line. Try to make it a three-point play.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
It's becoming a theme in this game, Clark. They are piling up the points in the paint. And for Chris Humphries, last year was a chance to sign with a playoff contender. The Wizards turned out to be even more than that, with the fourth best record in the East. And Humphries helped them to get there, averaging about 6.5 boards per game.
And Davis throws it down.
And gobbled up that rebound and went straight into attack mode on the putback.
He is one of the most determined rebounders, Clark, we have got in the NBA.
Yeah, you're calling it right, Kevin. I mean, he gets so many second chance points because of how hard he works to get to the rebound.
Teague can't hit.
He's having a tough quarter scoring the basketball and able to help him close this gap.
Here's Powell. A three-pointer, no good.
Well, he's gone without a field goal, and that certainly is below par for him. His team has still found a way to get it done.
A nice shot by Gallinari. 9 seconds left in the first half. To the inside. Two on the clock. And there's the nice layup by Plumlee. And the Clippers lead by four.
I love that dish down low.
And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Clippers lead by four. We'll be back shortly. Welcome back, everyone. We're ready to get going again as this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports continues. Players are topped off with Gatorade, hydrated, and ready to get going again as well.
What a stellar outing in this one for Thomas. 13 points, and he sprayed home three three-pointers as well.
This is really production personified from long range.
And so in the game for the Pacers. Nurkic is out there with Humphries. Then there's Teague. Then there's Gallinari. And it's Thomas in the one spot. Feeds to Teague. screen by Nurkic. Teague kicks to Thomas. Gallinari, the open look. Down to five on the shot clock. Connects, the jumper drops.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
Great anticipation and awareness to come up with the steal and trigger the fast break.
And now just a one-possession game thanks to that quick hitter. Outstanding play in the open court.
Adams, the pass to Bledsoe. Dishes it to Simmons. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist. Bledsoe's got four assists in the game.
8 of the last 10 points at that end of the court have been scored on very high percentage shots in the paint.
And really, there is no resistance defensively right now. It is just far too easy.
Pass to Humphries. Thomas against Bledsoe. Shot off the pick. It's hauled in by Adams.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Yes, fans, Clark, and the one team they view as floppers is the Clippers. I don't like that word, but it just kind of came out. Whether that is fair or not is up for debate, but it is certainly, I think, the perception.
And I think there's some truth to that perception. I mean, multiple players have received fines for flopping on their roster. I mean, you can't run away from that, and the fans remember it,
too.
Oh,
they do. Yes, sir. Nurkic dishes to Thomas. Teague kicks to Gallinari. Back to Teague. Pulls up on the wing. It's hauled in by the Clippers.
And for the Clippers, and part of it might just be reputation. Whenever anyone hits the deck on their team, fans might be quick to kind of condemn that as a flop.
DJ Augustine's checked in for Indiana.
You know, the Clippers were the darlings of the NBA as they improved and made strides, but I think the flopping has kind of diminished that now, that love affair. Being labeled a group of floppers can certainly stifle your popularity.
Out to Gallinari. And he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
And really nothing like a good old-fashioned throwdown to get a team going.
And Greg, they do need to get going. They wouldn't mind, you know, shaving a couple more points off that lead right away.
Well, if the defense keeps giving up easy baskets like that, it won't be a lead for long.
Back to Matthews. Here's Arthur. Los Angeles with another miss.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
Right side Teague. Uncovered. The basket is good. The assist from Augustine. Augustine's got 5 assists tonight. Bledsoe passes to Simmons. The feed to Adams. And the pass to Bledsoe. And play stops as it looks like they call an over the back here.
You know, right call. Gave the officials no choice there. I mean, they've got to make that call over the back.
Yeah, I mean, he went chest first into the man in front of him. My goodness, I'm not an official and I could have gotten that one right.
Matthews against T. Over to the wing. To tie. Augustine, no luck. Clippers leading by 3. Bledsoe gets to Matthews. Adams down low. Working on Nurkic. Count that one.
You gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of grinded out physical game.
That's the kind of look they can continue to go with. Maybe that'll help them create some separation on the scoreboard.
Ball's knocked loose. Stolen by Bledsoe. Here's Matthews. Make it 5 for 10 with him in that bucket. And what's your take, guys, on the hustle stats for Los Angeles?
Defensively, they played with a lot of energy, and the steals we've seen are a result of that aggressiveness.
You know, adding on to that, you look at their block totals tonight, and you see how feisty they've been on the defensive end this game.
T dishes to Nurkic, and the Pacers can't get it to go.
That's what we call good defense in the paint, worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy basket.
And he's trying to shoot his way out of it. You know, they have the lead, but honestly, I think it might help if he'd be a little bit more selective tonight.
Kicks to Augustine. He wants to get it to Nurkic and does. And good. Coming in on the assist by DJ Augustine.
Nice job creating for the easy deuce.
Greg, how about DJ Augustine and the roller coaster ride last season, beginning in Detroit, ending up in a very creditable position with the Oklahoma City Thunder?
And a lot of that was because Jennings was so inconsistent for Stan Van Gundy last year, even so much so that he started spot starting Augustine. And this was just a small part of the turmoil for Detroit last season.
Stevenson passes to Millsap. Can't get it to go. Great D that time from Davis. Clippers leading by five. Rivers kicks to Davis. Passes it to Powell. That's good. And the Clippers lead by seven. The Pacers have gone even 5 of 10 on shot attempts in the third. Augustine dishes to Stevenson. Tries from the block. Powell pulls it in. Los Angeles has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Now here's Rivers. He has seven. The shot by Powell, no good. Outside for Thomas. That drops. And now a 9-point Clipper lead. Pacers shooting in the second half so far about 45%. The dish to Stevenson. There's the pick. It's hauled in by the Clippers. Davis has got rebound number 12 here already in the game. Thomas again. It's going up. Thomas passes to Plumlee. Plenty of space. It's rebounded by Indiana. Millsap's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. And Augustine kicks to Millsap. Trying to find Kufis. Gets it to him. Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
Just a late reaction there from the defense, and he is always going to finish that one.
Rivers dishes to Thomas. Plumlee, the pass to Rivers. Plumlee with the screen. Thomas, it's a wide open look. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Stevenson outside. Outside Millsap. Let's a floater go. He dishes it to Kufis. For the three. That's good from Augustine. The assist by Kufis. Augustine's got five.
Of all the guys you want to leave open out on the perimeter, he is the absolute last guy on the list. Attention to detail. Know your personnel.
Powell kicks to Rivers. He feeds it to Powell. Rivers dishes to Thomas. That doesn't go either for Thomas. Pacers trail by four. Augustine with it. He's got five. He kicks it to Millsap. To the paint. Trying to find Augustine. Gets it to him. And he gets it to go.
You know, a huge height advantage there. But because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control is essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
And so it's Indiana with it. Millsap passes to Stevenson. Pass to Kufis. No good. That would have tied it.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be because he is so strong in the paint. And one bright note for the Pacers last season was the play of their bench. Adding Rodney Stuckey was a huge boost for them.
And the shot is good. And it's 9 points for Austin Rivers.
And look at how quick he was to bite on the pump fake. Left his feet way too soon.
Feeds it to Gallinari. They get the rebound. Kufis kicks to Stevenson. Down low. It's deflected. And so it looks like the Pacers will retain possession here.
And you know what? Just a little too much heat on that pass for him to come up with the steal.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, that was going to be a tough catch for either one of them.
Catching up on the changes now for Indiana. Dudley comes in for Gallinari. And it's Isaiah Thomas in for Augustine. Doubled by Plumlee. Thomas inside. He's guarded by Rivers. Four on the clock. Here's Dudley. And the Pacers can't get it to go. And Stuckey led the charge for the Pacers bench, Greg, as you were talking about. But all around, the reserves, Clark, were fantastic on the Pacers.
Yeah, third in the league at almost 41 points per game off the bench. First in the NBA in bench rebounding. And top 10 in field goal percentage as a bench.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over. You know, you work hard all season, Greg, to try and get into the playoffs, then get a favorable first-round matchup. How about the Clippers last year? Followed those steps. They're rewarded with the first-round matchup against the defending champions of the league, the San Antonio Spurs.
And not only were the Spurs the defending champions, but they came in playing terrific basketball down the stretch, which is kind of what they are noted for. And the Clippers, though, did well, even though that was the case.
Some changes for Indiana. Chris Humphries has checked in for Kufis. Smith comes in for Paul Millsap. And it's Henderson for Lance Stevenson. Thomas against Rivers to the wing on the left. Thomas dishes to Henderson. And Thomas, here we go. On its way from Dudley for two. Misses the wing J.
Boy, I tell you, it was a tough road for the Clippers in the playoffs. They get by the Spurs in round one in a 7-game emotional series and immediately have to go up against the Rockets in round two.
Davis sets a screen. Plumlee sets the pick for Thomas.
Yeah, but the hand in the face. It's critical that you contest his shots every time down the floor.
Here's Dudley. And released it in time, but it's... And that's going to do it for the third quarter. Los Angeles on top, leading by 6. And when we return, we'll get the fourth quarter rolling right here on 2K Sports. We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. Okay, now let's reset our lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this fourth quarter. And the Clippers, looking at who they've got. We've got Davis. Austin Rivers is out there with Powell. Then it's Miles Plumlee. And it's Thomas in at the three. Shot from 12. Humphries, no good. Los Angeles leading by 6. Up top, Rivers. He's guarded by Thomas. Rivers kicks to Thomas. And that's an air ball. Not even close. And Indiana shooting about 42% so far. Dishes to Humphries. Pass to Thomas. The feed to Smith. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. guys, Josh Smith, an interesting case. Clark, he shot about 2 triples a game last year, yet for the last 3 seasons, his free throw percentage has been under, surprisingly, 55%.
Yeah, and that's terribly troubling. I mean, his 3-point percentage improved in Houston, but the free throws, really, he can do much better than that. You look at his stroke, I think it's just a matter of concentration with Josh.
Looking at who's out there now for the Pacers. Nurkic checked in for Humphries. Molinari comes in for Jared Dudley. And it's Teague in for Gerald Henderson. They get it back.
Tell you what, he's a gutty player, guys. I mean, he's given away a lot of inches, a few inches anyway, and he still finds a way to win those rebound battles.
Here's Molinari. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
And with Smith and his shooting, a lot of it is mental. I mean, he has a terrific stroke from anywhere. The free throws are all in his head because he can make threes. He's just got to be a little more focused.
Plumlee with the screen. That doesn't go either for Thomas.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Scooped up. Outside for Thomas. Back to Nurkic. To the inside. Thomas, good. Thomas got it all tied up now for the Pacers.
And, you know, thinking again about Smith, he made some big shots for the Rockets last year, but you never know quite what you're going to get with him taking perimeter shots.
That doesn't go either for Thomas.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, you may not be as lucky next time down if you're the defense. You cannot allow him to get those kinds of looks.
Powell. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. And the Clippers lead by 2.
Not his best game, but they're still getting it done collectively.
Teague left side. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot 2. Well, you just watch Jeff Teague. He's a natural scorer. Clark, he's also made steady improvement as a playmaker.
Yeah, you look at his assist rate, Kevin. Well in the top 10 in the league. He's cut down on his turnovers as well. You can tell he's starting to really figure it out, and the game is slowing down for him.
A platoon swap here for the Clippers. Then for the Pacers. Kufis checked in for Nurkic. Millsap comes in for Smith. And Dudley subbed in for Gallinari. Matthews passes to Simmons. Good work defensively by Millsap.
And he's also athletic. You know, sometimes you forget that. I mean, this guy's got the tools also to be a terrific defender. And I still think he's developing consistency at that end of the floor.
Dudley's shot is good. Guys, what a game. 8 lead changes here.
Yeah, and nobody giving up any ground either way, fella.
And don't be surprised if it comes down to the last possession.
And Matthews gets it to go.
And speaking of Jeff Teague's defense, I mean, his rebounding, I think, could also be a little higher. I mean, with his bounce, he can get in there and grab a few more.
Thomas picks to Millsap. Thomas trying to break loose. Arthur grabs the board. Arthur's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Bledsoe dishes to Arthur. And a great assist by Bledsoe as that one goes in. Bledsoe's got 5 assists tonight. And the Pacers call time here. One of the stories here, Wesley Matthews getting it done today.
They don't seem to have any answers for him. They need to review their game plan and look for a way to cool him off.
And the thing about Eric Bledsoe, he's an absolutely terrific athlete, insane athletic ability, his speed with the ball, especially Greg in the open court, remarkable.
Yeah, he gets a full head of steam. Look out. He goes beast mode, if you will, and on the basketball floor. He really, truly is like a running back in the open field.
Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Yes, sir. Kevin, I was able to hear the advice Frank Vogel gave to his team during that last break. He told his guys, time's running low. If we're going to make our move, it's going to be now. Are you guys ready? And as they nodded, he said, let's go get it. Kevin?
Talking about Bledsoe, one area where he has to improve is turnovers. He averaged over 3.5 turnovers a game. You can't be a championship point guard if you're not squeezing the orange.
Kufis, the best to Stevenson. Tries it from the top of the key. And off the front iron, and in it goes. Stevenson's got 4 points this quarter. Time running low, guys, and somebody has got to win this one.
This game, as close as it's been, you really hate to see it come to an end.
I agree.
Yeah, well, who knows? We might need overtime in this one. It's been that kind of a game. And thinking a little bit more about Eric Bledsoe, yes, he could be more efficient. But his combination of points, assists, and rebounds per game is outstanding. If he focuses in and listens to his coaches, we could be talking about him in the upper echelon of point guard.
Here's Simmons. That's good. Basket number 5 on a 5-for-8 night shooting.
Loose D here. Critical stretch. I mean, you're better off sending him to the free throw lines than to have them get that good a look.
There's the pass to Dudley. At the top of the key, Millsap. Inside. Here's Stevenson.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the rack.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that.
Here is Bledsoe. Here's Simmons. And stolen by Kufis. And here we go. Stevenson heading to the hoop. Got a piece of it. And even 3-on-3 break. And he's going to get whistled for that foul, G. That was intentional, but not exactly logical.
How about pointless to foul there? I mean, I don't know where his head is, but it's not in the game.
Time called here. Indiana decides to talk it over.
And Costa Kufis, an excellent rotation center. I mean, he gets after it on the inside. He'll give you some rebounds, can block some shots. He's made himself into a factor.
And Kufis not really a shooter, Clark. He does his damage around the rim.
Yeah, he really does. The former Buckeye is a great screen setter. He attacks the offensive glass, plays within himself, and knows his role, and he does it well.
And the Clippers making a change here. Thomas has checked in. Jeff Teague, he's checked in for the Pacers. Shots good by Bledsoe.
Big time bucket there, and you can expect to see him stay very involved the rest of the way.
Teague kicks it up. Stolen by Bledsoe. It's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Been a really good night for Eric Bledsoe. 9 points, and he's come away with 2 steals as well. He's blown up some plays out there.
And it also shows you the importance of intelligence as a defender, because he has been a nightmare on the ball.
One thing about Eric Bledsoe, he made it clear he wanted to be paid like an upper-tier player. And that led to quite a negotiation between he and the Suns last year. Ultimately, the two sides agreed to a 5-year, $70 million deal.
Outside Matthews. Thomas a screen. Matthews dishes to Bledsoe. Here's Stevenson. A great 1-2 punch. Beautiful pass and nasty jam.
Well, you talk about clutch plays defensively and offensively. We saw both right there.
And the gap's narrowing right now, Clark. Every second from here on out counts. Neither team can afford. Oh!
Man, he got that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the momentum boost they need to break this game open.
I tell you what, I like that, though, guys. Some coaches might not want you to make a play like that. But I tell you what, when you got the skills like that, I say go for it.
He had a couple in the first, but so far he's been unable to get uncorked here.
Kicks it to Kufis. It's tipped. Here's Simmons. Oh, and that one, no question, powered it down. And guys, here in the fourth quarter, still a close game.
Yeah, and actually still too close to call. I mean, this one is tight.
Instant classic, fellas. This one could come right down to the last shot.
Teague against Bledsoe. Clock at six. Here's Millsap. Somehow ignores the tight D and gets the layup. And the Pacers lead by one. Now Matthews. Adams outside. Matthews goes in. And another field goal in this total. Make it 7 for 14, shooting 50%. Indiana's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Stevenson outside. And Paul Millsap, the bucket on the assist from Stevenson. And it's 13 points for Paul Millsap.
Nothing too fancy, just simple execution. That's getting the job done when they need to make every possession count.
Completely agree with that, Clark. They need stops and really can't afford any wasted possessions. Those inside shots are nice, high-percentage looks.
Thomas gets the bucket.
And you can just see by the way he fought for the putback that he still got a lot of gas in the tank.
Teague against Bledsoe. Outside Teague. Bentley the pass to Teague. He gets hauled in by Los Angeles. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Bledsoe with it. Now guarded by Stevenson. Bledsoe gets to Matthews. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist. Now it's a 4-point Los Angeles lead.
Watch out. Now that he's got his first three of the half, there might be more in store.
And the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That's his first foul. There's 1:17 left in the fourth quarter. Kufis. Oh, took the contact and tried to throw it down over the top. But instead, he'll shoot free throws.
Wow, that is a strong move there to go in for the dunk.
And I like the job the defense did to not let him have it. I mean, make him earn it at the line.
And Kufis drops them both.
That was essential that he cashed in on those free throws. They're within one possession.
Los Angeles has gone 2 of 5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. And Bledsoe, here we go. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot 2 right here. He doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really want. He's got one more, though.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here. Aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
Yusuf Nurkic, he's checked in for the Pacers. Isaiah Thomas comes in for Lance Stevenson. Thomas kicks it up. Just 5 to shoot. Thomas goes in.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Yeah, it looked like it. I mean, he kind of slid underneath as he got to the spot, too.
Gerald Henderson, he's checked in for T. He's able to hit the second one, and that gives them a 4-point cushion. Timeout called, the Pacers. They're trailing by 4. There's 38 seconds left in the fourth. Some changes for Indiana. comes in for Jared Dudley. And Ellington is subbed in for Gerald Henderson. And out of bounds as the Clippers gain possession.
Well, that's inexcusable to throw a pass that far off the mark.
Outside Matthews. To the paint. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Matthews.
Boy, did they ever make a mess out of that one. A terrible turnover.
29 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Right wing deflects the pass. It's stolen by Adams. And Matthews throws it down.
And really, I like the fact that even with the big lead, they never coast.
To me, that's a sign of a really good team, Greg, because you should always be playing against the game and yourself. I know there's an opponent out there, but when you have a lead, it's all about continuing to execute. Do what you do. And stay true to that. And I like that aggressiveness and full speed ahead kind of attack that they have.
Had to foul, and on that occasion to stop the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
And you know what, Greg? Who knows? A few misses at the stripe, and they're right there within range. You know, late game free throws are a lot different than early game free throws in terms of making.
Three-pointer Ellington. Can't get it to go. And so Los Angeles takes the win. Probably a little closer than they would have liked it, but Clark, a win nonetheless.
Yeah, and it appeared to me as though the fans gave them the emotional boost they needed down the stretch, Kevin. This crowd was not going to let this one slip away.
And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. Now we'll head over to the award-winning Ernie Johnson, who's not too far away. EJ?